10 creepiest parasites in the world. Number 10. Cordyceps fungus actually grows into the brain of insects, progressively devouring the host's brain until the insect dies. Once this occurs, Cordyceps grows as a fungus out of the head of its dead host. Some Cordyceps are known to even force their insect hosts to crawl to the top of plants before they die. That way, once the Cordyceps emerge out of the insect host, it can rain down spores on the ground floor, infecting even more insects, who will also become fungi. Oddly enough, some people eat the mushroom product of Cordyceps as a soup. Number 9. If you see a snail with two beautiful eye stalks, pulsating with emerald and olive green stripes, and dappled with charcoal gray flecks, capped off with a maroon dab, be impressed. You're not just looking at a pimped out snail. You're looking at a snail infected with a parasitic flatworm. The green banded broodsac first squirms its way into the stalks of the snail, so that they look like juicy, pulsing, brightly colored caterpillars. This is just the kind of snack nearby birds are in the mood for. Then the worm manipulates the snail's behavior. It is found that the infected snails behaved differently from their apparently non-infected counterparts. They position themselves in the more exposed and better lit places, situated higher in the vegetation. This probably makes the snails more conspicuous for foraging birds. Once eaten by the birds, the worm can reproduce, and the cycle continues. Number 8. Sacculina, a genus of barnacles that contain multiple species, would definitely be at the top of our list if it affected humans. The barnacles find an unsuspecting crab, and then form a sac right where the crab's own eggs would be, if it's female, sterilizing the crab and preventing it from ever producing its own offspring. The sac is fertilized by a male Sacculina, and when the Sacculina eggs are ready to hatch out of the sac, the crab actually tends to them as if they are her own offspring, performing normal crab birthing procedures. The really scary thing is that if the crab host is male, the barnacles mess with the crab's hormones, making it more feminine so it can better lay the eggs. The crab then acts like a female crab and even performs mating gestures associated with females. Number 7. This parasitic insect, Glyptapanteles, is quite unique in the way it plays with its food. The wasp finds a caterpillar and injects its eggs into its body cavity where they grow into larvae and begin to eat the caterpillar's insides. Here is where it gets interesting. The caterpillar continues to act normal, going about its business until around 80 larvae drill holes in its body and crawl out of it. The larvae create cocoons around the caterpillar, who remains around the cocoons until the wasps emerge and the caterpillar dies. This behavior was a mystery until scientists recently discovered that the larvae somehow turn the caterpillar into a bodyguard. The caterpillar defends the cocoons against anything that comes near it, swinging itself violently against nearby insects that frequently fall off branches onto the ground. Number 6. This parasitic crustacean, Cymothoa exigua, does something you probably didn't know was possible. It replaces fish's tongues. The process begins when Cymothoa exigua swims into the mouth of a fish and begins to prey on its host's tongue. The parasite sucks all the blood from the tongue until the tongue withers from atrophy and falls off. After Cymothoa exigua has fed off the original tongue, it attaches its claws to the tongue muscles and proceeds to actually replace the tongue in the fish's mouth while feeding off blood and mucus. The host fish is now able to permanently use this crustacean as a completely functional tongue. Number 5. This wasp has an odd way of giving birth. The female parasitic Polysphincta gutfreundi will find a spider on its web and lay an egg on its abdomen. A larva then emerges out of the egg and begins drinking the spider's vital fluids for nourishment. That's not even the worst of it. Not only does the larva drink up the spider's insides until it dies, the larva secretes a chemical into the spider that completely changes the spider's instinctual behavior. Instead of tending to its own web, the spider creates a stronger, chemically enhanced web with a different pattern designed for the growing wasp larva. After the spider is nothing but a shriveled shell, the larva attaches itself to the new web and creates a cocoon in which it matures into a grown wasp, high above potential predators. Number 4. Also known as the Lancet Fluke, Dicrocoelium dendriticum essentially makes ants offer themselves to be eaten. When an ant becomes infected with the Lancet Fluke, the parasite takes control of its nerves and controls the ant's behavior. Every night, the ant will now crawl to the top of a plant, where the parasite forces it to clamp down tightly and wait. The perfect place to be eaten by some grazing cattle. The Lancet Fluke puts its ant host on a metaphorical platter, because it can only carry out its life cycle in the gut of the large grazers that typically prey on ants. What's also interesting is that since the ant, and thus its parasitic friend, would die from sun exposure if it was on the leaf during the day, the Lancet Fluke allows the ant to act normally when the sun is out. Although humans can contract the Lancet Fluke, it usually just leads to bowel discomfort. Number 3. Vandalia curosa, also known as the Candiru or vampire fish, is scary not so much because it drinks your blood from inside you, but because of how it can get inside you. Normally, the Amazon's Candiru, a type of catfish that is typically a few inches long, follows the smell of ammonia to larger fish, where it climbs into their gills. When there, it shoots out its sharp spine, lodging itself in its host's gills, where it proceeds to engorge on blood. Here's the really scary part. When humans urinate, we also excrete ammonia, and there have been confirmed cases of the Candiru swimming up a urine stream into the victim's penis. Once there, it will drink your blood until you have the very invasive and very painful surgery to get it out. Number 2. Loa loa, also known as the eye worm, is a parasitic worm that lives within humans and other mammals' bodies specifically. As you might suspect, eyes. Loa loa is contracted from certain flies, and after an infected fly bites its victim, the worm begins floating around tissue of the bitten host. The worm travels along the tissue, moving through the body, until it stops and causes swelling and irritation in that spot. The creepiest thing about loa loa is that if it gets up to your eye tissue, you can actually feel it moving around in your eye. It can also be seen flowing around in there, if it's big enough. Luckily, the worm is easily killed using antibiotics or extracted through relatively minor surgery. And by the way, this worm can live inside a human for up to 17 years. Number 1. Toxoplasma gondii is a feline-related parasite that is only able to reproduce inside cats and is commonly found in cat feces. How does it get there, you ask? When rats and mice are infected with T. gondii, they actually become attracted to cats. Specifically their smell, which is obviously supposed to trigger fear in the rodents. This effect is beneficial to the parasitic protozoa because cats easily kill the infected rodent and become the new host of Toxoplasma gondii. Humans didn't become attracted to cats when infected, but we do contract toxoplasma from the parasite, which can cause brain damage to fetuses. This is the reason pregnant women are advised to stay away from cat litter. Perhaps scarier, new studies have shown that toxoplasma may be related to schizophrenia in humans.